right now. But there were moments back in the second and fourth when you thought that Tyson would have it in the bag, but he couldn't finish Ronick off.
Hey, the third round was an action round for Ruddock. He was doing great. You wondered how Mike could take that hammering. Now in the later round, can he take that hammering if it happens to him again? Oh, nice uppercut. Two nice uppercuts by Razor Ruddock. Oh, low blow, low blow, low blow
by Tyson and Mills Lane.
And that cost him 1 point.
Takes the point away from Tyson. And that's the second time he's been penalized in the fight.
It's amazing Tyson didn't take a punch at the lonesome dove, Mills Lane. He looked at him like saying, what, you're going to take a point from me?
Well,
he had been warned twice. That's the third one.
If he did, he'd be taking a punch at a possible future governor of Nevada or senator.
If he can, oh, nice.
Good left by Ruddock.
Wonderful left by Ruddock. Again, the low blow. Again, another low blow. By Tyson, two low blows by Tyson.
That left hand by Ruddock has been called the smash by Art Hayles, his trainer. It's a blindsiding punch, very difficult to see.
I don't know about difficult to see, but it must be difficult to take because that was hard.
Difficult to see, but you feel it. Oh, what a left hand by Razor Ruddock. It got through, Purdy.
He faked the right hand and went right up the middle. He just didn't have power with it.
But it certainly penetrated.
It was right on the button.
In the Think it's unbelievable how you give them to their hands.
Give it. celebrating 25 years as the Network of Champions. This has been a presentation of HBO Sports.
HBO Boxing After Dark.
Tide has turned. Here comes Gotti. Look at this. He has put some hurt on Holiday in this round. Herrera is known as a great finisher. Blood, guts, and glory in Boston.
Madison Square Garden, March 8, 1971. This bout was the first of what would become one of the greatest rivalries this sport has ever seen.
Change up, then go right hook to the body. You're doing it. But you got to follow through, Michael. Keep punching. Don't let this guy get off the hook. And don't wait outside. Be first.
All out.
All right. Move. Let's go. Michael, can't take no chances. They took points off. You got to go to work. Keep jabbing it. Keep jabbing, go to work. You're doing it when you're jabbing right middle. Ground. Look. Boom, boom, right hand, left hook. Come on. On feet.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Don Dunphy. I'll be calling the blow-by-blow for this championship match, an event of such magnitude, it has been referred to around the world as the fight of the century.
Welcome to another heavyweight championship match under the promotion of Herman Taylor and the International Boxing Club. The officials for this contest, assigned by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission, judges Pete Tomasco and Zach Clayton. Counting for the knockdown, Joe Servino. Physicians in attendance at ringside in Walcott's corner, Dr. Joseph Bartone. In Marciano's corner, Dr. W.B.G. Terry. And the field physician, Dr. James J. Simpkins. The referee at this time, Charlie Daggett. The main attraction, 15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world from Brockton, Massachusetts, wearing black trunks with a white stripe, weighing 184 pounds, the challenger, Rocky Marciano. From Camden, New Jersey, wearing white trunks with a black stripe, weighing 196 pounds, the heavyweight champion, Jersey Joe Walcott.
Now we'll listen to referee Charlie Daggett and his instructions.
I know the rules of the State Boxing Commission, and I'm in here to enforce them. Now, all I'm going to do is go through just a few, leave me out of it. Number one, when I call for a break, I want both boys to step back. If I don't call for a break, keep on fighting. Is that clear to both others? In case of a knockdown, a man scoring it, I want to go to the furthest neutral corner, stay there until I tell him to come out. I want your blows up. I don't want no kidney punches or rattles. Take hands now. come out fight. Any questions?
There's no 8 pounds.
There's no knockdown 8 pounds. You get up and stay down. Shake hands.
Can I ask a question?
Right.
How about if a man gets hit in the back here? Is that a fair or foul punch?
I ask both you boys to give me no kidney or no rabbit punches. I'm going to call them if I do.
What's them punches around?
I want both of you to be, give me an honest, clean fight. That's all I'm in here to do.
Yes, sir, ma'am. The man is holding, the other fellow is punching. He can keep punching.
Right,
the Municipal Stadium in Philadelphia, and you folks are sitting in with crowds in 49 theaters in 39 cities coast to coast on this theater network television, the biggest in history, and we do hope you'll see a good fight, and we know you'll see it in comfort, and we'll do our best to tell you anything that we see that's important. Here they go. It is professed to believe that Marciano is an amateur, and looks as if he might be going right to work on it. Staggered with a short right. Down from a left hook.